as your quick brain challenge, or quick challenge, if you will, imagine this. Imagine you have a thought experiment where you did this every single day, if you're willing. What if the only things in your life tomorrow are the things you express gratitude for today? Let me say that again. What if the only things in your life you had, the people, the opportunities, the resources, the objects, all the things, what if the only things you kept tomorrow are the things you've expressed gratitude for today? Would you live differently? Of course, we all would. And how does it feel to feel grateful? It's amazing, right? Because somebody can have everything and not appreciate it, and it feels like they have nothing. But somebody could have very little resources, but they feel so grateful and appreciative. They like have everything, all right? And so what I want you to do as part of your challenge today is to express your gratitude in one of two ways. You could express it with people around you, and that's wonderful. Talk to your family, talk to your friends, express gratitude for the person that lives or delivers your mail, wherever you are, express gratitude for them. And or express gratitude in a journal. A lot of people, they like to express gratitude by writing things down. So it's verbally is great, but also writing things down kinesthetically. There's something about putting pen to paper and to be able to see all those things. Some people, what they'll do is they'll write on a little note card one thing they're grateful for that day, and they'll put it into like a fishbowl. And then at the end of like 365 days after a year, they just go and read all those things. And I even just get goosebumps thinking about that. I call them truth bumps, but it just, how do you come alive that way? And so my challenge for you today is you deserve to feel like you have more than you think you have. Like if you want to feel truly wealthy, count all of the things you have in your life that money cannot buy. Count, just write down in your gratitude journal or notebook all the things you have in your life that you wouldn't give away for any amount of money, all right? And then you could be able to feel what it really feels like to feel truly wealthy, because we have more than we think we have, even through the challenges. Even I've learned through my challenges of learning, my challenges of public speaking, that sometimes there's a gift in it. And if you start to train yourself to look for it, what we look for, we find, right? You know this, like if you just see a yellow car, you start seeing yellow cars everywhere because it becomes important to you. What if you start asking yourself, what do I feel most grateful for? You start seeing that, and you're where your focus goes, your energy flows, and you start having more of that. What if you start looking for opportunity more? A lot of people are really good at seeing the negative, right? Do you know somebody like this? Maybe somebody too personally, where they're really good at seeing what's wrong. You could also train yourself and rewire your brain through gratitude practices to see what's right. And what you see, you start seeing more of. So ask yourself the question, what am I grateful for right now? Or if you say nothing, what could I be grateful for right now? So here's your quick brain challenge, is to write three things down and post it that you're grateful for today. Either take a picture of your journal or take a picture of something you are grateful for, post it online and say, this is what I'm grateful for today. And ask your friends, what are you grateful for? Because that's a great question and gift you could give them. So are you up for the challenge, Quick Brains? I know you are. This is gonna be a fun one. Write down or post some of your favorite things that you're grateful for right at the moment. It doesn't have to be the biggest things in the world, because what you appreciate appreciates. And you're gonna find that you're gonna have more and more to be grateful for, because a little by little, a little becomes a lot. I think one of the greatest prayers that we have are the simple words, thank you. Just saying thank you, giving thanks. So I wanna thank you for watching this episode, listening to this episode. Thank you for participating in our quick challenge.